Hello everyone, welcome to How Fix It. In this step-by-step tutorial, I'll show you how to replace the front camera, Face ID module, on the iPhone 15 Pro. Before we start disassembling, let me show you the tools you'll need. Screwdriver set. Plastic pry tools. Suction cup. Tweezers. Screen disassembly tool. Adhesive sealant tape. I have included links to all the tools and spare parts in the video description below. I also advise using a magnetic mat throughout the disassembly process, especially for repairing a device like an iPhone. While disassembling, manage each screw's placement to ensure accurate reassembly. And you don't have to worry about the screws getting lost. They will all securely adhere to the magnetic mat. So, let's get started. Turn off your iPhone and proceed to remove the two screws located near the charging port. Use a hairdryer to heat the bottom edge of the iPhone for approximately 1 minute, ensuring that the screen becomes slightly hot to the touch. Fix the suction cup to the screen's bottom edge and pull it up. Insert the blade into the thin gap between the screen and the chassis. From this position, gradually begin to separate the screen. The gap between the screen and the iPhone chassis is really small and hard to pry, which is why I consider this screen disassembly tool the most effective for safely removing iPhone screens. The adhesive holding the screen is quite strong, and the opening procedure requires some time. If you can't create a gap, heat the screen even more and gently separate the adhesive until you make a sufficient gap to insert a plastic spudger. When opening the top of the iPhone case, avoid pushing the prying tool too deeply into the case to prevent damage to the components of the Face ID module. Open the screen with extreme caution. Make an effort to avoid sudden movements, because the screen is still connected to the mainboard. Abruptly separating the screen from the iPhone body can damage the screen cable. Remove the screws on the bracket securing the battery and display connectors. Remember, each screw has its place, so keep them organized for later reassembly. Use a plastic spudger to disconnect the battery cable. Next, disconnect the display cables and remove the screen. Replacing the Face ID module on the iPhone is a quick process, taking around 5 minutes. But it comes with specific requirements, which I'll explain shortly. Remove the earpiece speaker. Disconnect the Face ID cables from the mainboard. Now you can remove the Face ID module. Here's what you should know when replacing the Face ID module on your iPhone. The Face ID module is intricately linked to the iPhone logic board and the light sensor located on the display. So, when you replace the Face ID module with any other, even if it's the original one from the same iPhone, the facial recognition function will not work. However, you can separately replace the front camera in the Face ID module. The Face ID module comprises of an infrared camera, a front camera, and a dot projector. The infrared and dot projector are crucial components of the Face ID and cannot be replaced. However, you can replace the front camera. To replace the front camera, you will need to disassemble the Face ID module, so be cautious not to damage the module during this process. In the video description, I provided the link where you can find the Face ID module for spare parts. Now that it's all back together, let's test your iPhone to ensure everything is functioning. Check the replaced module to ensure it functions correctly. If everything works fine, let's proceed with the final step of assembly and restoring water protection. Remove old adhesive tape from your iPhone's case. Use isopropyl alcohol and a cotton swab to remove any remaining smaller bits of adhesive. Carefully align the edge of the adhesive tape with the iPhone case. Use a spudger to press all the adhesive into place and around the entire perimeter of your iPhone. Thank you. Grab the small pull tab and peel the front liner from the adhesive. Press the display around the entire perimeter to secure its position. Then, fasten the last two screws located near the charging port. If you found this guide helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more tech tips and guides. Visit our website for more tech insights and do-it-yourself guides. Remember, every tech challenge is an opportunity to learn and grow. Well done, the repair is now complete. You were on How Fix It, and see you again next time.